David, how's the summer been going for you?
Quick. Just get back from the World Championships, and next thing you know, you're at the draft. But it's been pretty good so far. It's been a good summer for us as an organization.
Sharks have been pretty busy in a free agency. What do you know about any of the guys that they brought, whether via free agency or trade?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, we're really happy with all our additions. You know, we're kind of talking yesterday about, you know, in a year, how much better we feel about our organization and the direction we're going, some of the changes we've made. And it's just exciting right now as an organization, whether it be some of the players we've acquired through free agency, trades, or draft.
What can you tell us about what you know of Mackenzie Blackwood, Kyle Burrows, just to start?
Yeah, obviously, Blackwood, you know, has had a tough 2 years from an injury standpoint. He was, I thought, one of the better goalies in the league, young goalies coming up when he was with New Jersey, when I was with the Rangers. And, you know, he's a young goalie still. And, you know, if he stays healthy, we really think we've got something, a guy that can, you know, carry this organization for a while. And, you know, Burrows is a hard-nosed defenseman. You know, makes life difficult for the opponent, stands up for his teammates. So, you know, that's certainly something that we want to add to our organization. And he's the right shot.
And how important is it to add a guy like Giovanni Smith to sort of protect everybody?
Yeah, and he can do more than that. Yeah. That's something that as an organization we were aware of and cognizant of when we add people. You got to play hockey too. You know, he's a very effective player in a lot of different ways. That's probably his calling, is to be a physical guy and, you know, protect his teammates, but also establish a forecheck and be responsible defensively. So, you know, there's a lot of things that go into putting a team together, and, you know, Mike's certainly in the process of doing that.
Yeah, what do you know about Anthony Duclair?
Former 30-goal scorer, a guy that went through a tough injury last year, played well in the playoffs, and I'm as excited to have him as Couture and Hurdle are. Yeah, he certainly fits in the mold of the way we want to play, and, you know, we're very excited to get him.
You got a chance to talk to him?
Yes. Yeah, he's excited. He's excited for a lot of reasons. Obviously, they had a lot of success this year. He was, you know, frustrated the fact that he was injured last year and, you know, was only able to play the last 20 games, and then, you know, obviously he started getting his feet under him and had a really good playoff. So, you know, but he's very excited about this opportunity here. That's the thing about us. I mean, I know everyone's aware of the situation we're in. We've got two elite centers that can excite people when they come here, you know. So that's certainly something that, you know, Anthony's aware of.
I know your mind kind of toy around with some line combinations already. Where does they declare it might fit best?
On the top two lines and on the power play, you know, depending on what we do moving forward here. You know, there's still 2 months before training camp, and a lot can change between now and training camp. So, you know, as a coach, you kind of, you're thinking about what lines might look like, but you just got to wait until the roster's set.
You mentioned, like, just sitting around and thinking about all the changes. Just whenever you look at the defensive depth chart, even like the guys that are out here, I know you weren't here last summer, but right. Just how different is it?
It's very different. I think you guys probably, jumps out at you probably more than me, because you guys were here last year, about the depth and the size and the prospects that we have. We just have a much deeper prospect pool right now, and, you know, Mike and Joe and Tom and the rest of our staff have done a heck of a job in a short period of time of increasing our prospect pool.
You kind of look forward to that competition at camp. You've got a lot of guys kind of knocking on the door here. Obviously, Henry and that makes two.
Yeah.
You're just talking to Camille. You're just talking to Cooley. He's obviously been pro for a couple of years,
yeah,
too. Kind of look forward to that.
Yeah, I mean, to me, it really brings out the best in all the players when you've got people that they know are pushing them and competing for the same spots. And, you know, that's what successful organizations have. They have competition in all three positions, and, you know, we're getting there, that's for sure.
You know, obviously, Eric made his feelings pretty clear at the award show there. Obviously, like you predicted.
I didn't go out there, though. It was all him.
You know, how much of you kind of just follow that situation? And what does this defense score, as it kind of slips right now, have to do to, if you need to replace it, to sort of just fill that void if that were to happen?
Well, listen, I'm not the general manager, and he's still here until he's not. And when I look about looking forward to our D-Corps. He's on. And if he's not here, it looks a lot different, but certainly if he's not here, there's probably people coming back and opens up an opportunity for us to maybe get somebody else. So it's really a status quo situation. We've just got to hold and wait to see what we look like in September. But I've made it clear to how we feel about him as an organization. I mean, he was phenomenal in so many ways last year, on and off the ice. And you know, we had a season for the ages for defensemen. You know, fourth leading scorer in the National Hockey League, 5-on-5. I mean, really, that says it all. And, you know, just really happy for him. And it was a tough few years leading into last year from an injury standpoint. And, you know, when he's healthy, he's certainly shown that he's the best defenseman in this league.
If he's not here, how much do you have to sort of change, like, the way that the forecheck looks like, the way that you guys defend? I mean, how does that, does it all kind of have to be sort of reimagined in a way without a guy like him?
I wouldn't say much, you know. I mean, your system isn't tailored to one guy. So, you know, we've talked as a staff, and we've still got 2.5 months to camp. So you sit here and like, oh, no, we're here. And, you know, there's a lot of time to make some adjustments. Obviously, most of us were together at the World Championship. So, you know, there were a lot of hockey discussions then of what we might tweak a little bit this year. And there will be some tweaks to how we play. But our identity is going to be the same. As an organization, we've talked about how we want to play, how we want to look, and but you know, structurally, we might alter a few things. And as we touched on, as you know, talking to you guys last year and internally, we have to be very careful in judging the final numbers. I'm more consumed with how we looked, you know, mid-January, from October to mid-January, because that's probably much more realistic to, you know, how we're going to look this year compared to how it ended, because you know we were in a different position the last 6 weeks to 2 months of the season with all the changes we made and the way our roster looked. So, you know, that's, you know, we all remember the last 6-7 weeks, but we've got to be diligent in how we evaluate ourselves.
You mentioned size. Mike has mentioned size 3 or 4 times, I think, over the last year and change. Why is that important? Why did you need all these big guys?
Well, you need good big guys. You can't just go get size, and I think that's something that we've done a good job of. We've gotten good big hockey players. You just don't get big, right? What good does big do if you can't play? You got to be able to play, and we've gotten good big hockey players. And you know, it's just something that over the course of 4 or 5 years, we've gotten a little bit smaller as an organization. So, you know, maybe it's cyclical on how you draft or how you put your team together. So, but you know, we've gotten good big hockey players, and that. Just look at the playoffs. I mean, big. You know, we all talk about the speed and the skill in this game, and it has improved. But you know, playoff hockey starts, and it's you better have some size, especially on the blue line.
How did the Sharks prospects do in the World Championships? My dad held them.
They did well. They did well. It was a good tournament for them.
What do you see?
Not a good tournament the way it ended for us, but a good tournament for some individuals.
I didn't ask about that.
I know, but I can't help myself.
What have you seen from Will Smith and Quentin Musty so far at camp? Obviously, it's only been 2 days, but you know, first round picks. What have you liked from their game? What have you seen from them?
Well, certainly you see the skill set with Will and the pace he plays at and his shot and his vision and his intelligence. And with Musty, boy, you know, I'd never seen him play, but very impressive what he's done here in a short period of time. But that being said, everybody has to be careful with what we're seeing and what we're watching. And, you know, these are all, I mean, it's all great to see him in this situation, but you know, our game's always about what can you do when someone's trying to stop you from doing it. So, you know, but they certainly show a lot of characteristics that you need to be successful at this level.
You talk about competitive, so I know you brought that up, and Mike has brought that up as well. Is that something along with size that you guys have brought in? Just the compete level of the entire organization seems to be higher.
Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, unlike any other sport, I think effort and compete can really neglect talent in hockey compared to all the other sports because it's played in such a small area. And it's played so fast. So, you know, those are two areas that we've really highlighted over the last year.
What I should say, when you guys are looking at prospects, what characteristics or tendencies do you see anything in the ice that describe their effort or their compete level?
Well, just how competitive they are. You know, are they getting to the battle? Not only are they just getting there, you know, what are their intentions when they get to the battle? Are they trying to, you know, they all into it, or are they just getting there? And that's a big difference between getting to a battle and being in the battle. I mean, you know, you can't just get there to get there. You got to be there with an attitude and a purpose, and that's certainly something we've been aware of and looking for when we've evaluated our prospects.
What is all the other? I mean, you haven't seen a lot of Shakir yet, but obviously Mike has known him for a few years, and yeah. Your development guys have been around him. He's kind of like a big mystery box. Like, what are they saying about him?
I mean, a lot of, you know, we watched some film on him, and Scotty Gord, for the first, you know, when Scotty watched him for the first time, he really was impressed with what he saw. Abilities and the capabilities of him as a prospect. I mean, that size, that skating, you know, his puck decisions, there's an awful lot to like for him. And, you know, he's still young, very young. And we've got to keep that in check and not put too much pressure on him and, you know, let his career evolve and let his play dictate when's the right time to give him an opportunity or let him earn the opportunity to play in the National Hockey League. Because sometimes when you rush people, it's detrimental to their development and you can really stunt some careers.
Obviously, getting a guy like DeClaire is obviously a huge addition, but obviously means that Steve Lawrence is right now. And obviously, he's a guy who really established himself. He's like a great penalty killer,
reliable.
Yes.
How do you look at that competition now going into Canada? Does a Warlow fit in that sort of mold of being a fourth line center, or do you look just maybe a big body in that position?
Well, I think you can use him. You know, he's got a great opportunity here to make our team, and you know, I know how he feels. He feels that this is time to, you know, get it done. You know, he's in his third year with us, and you know, it's time. You know, I know he feels that way. There's an opportunity here for him. You know, where he fits and what position he plays is going to be predicated on how he plays. And then, but like I said, our roster looks the way it does today. You know, September 21st, it might look completely different. You just never know. So. You know, but as we stand here today, he's got an incredible opportunity, and I thought his last game of the year was his best game. And you know, he and I had a couple of conversations prior to that game and post game, and you know, I think he's excited about the opportunity, but he has to take advantage of it. Oh yeah, yeah, he looks good. He looks good. He feels good. He's going to be ready for training.
It's time for a few more.
Being a guy who could, you know, really kind of reset.
Absolutely. And, you know, I said this to Eki when we sent him down last year. You know, from a coaching standpoint, it was frustrating because he was playing well and we wanted to keep him. But you certainly understand the situation we were in as an organization, and it was the right thing to do. We want to make the playoffs down the Barracuda. It's a big part of development. And you know, obviously, shoulder became more of an issue, and it was unfortunate the way the season ended.
I'm wondering about Bortoloa. Obviously, started the season at center, end of the season at wing. Sounds like pretty open either way with what position he
right.
plays, but you know, does he know? Like, have you guys told him, like, hey, kind of focus on maybe you might start on the wing? I mean, just what is, you know, what have you told him? What have you guys told him about that?
We haven't talked with him. I haven't talked with him about that. Again, it's all depending on what our rosters will look like in September. You know, as he's alluded to, he can play either position. He just wants to play hockey at the National Hockey League level. So his versatility helps him for sure.
Have you seen though with him that maybe at this point in his career might be more comfortable at center, at least professionally, than wing?
Yeah, I think it's a little too early to tell. I think he's had enough opportunity here at center to really say one way or another.